energy, energy don't come again. So today I'm gonna be doing a story time for you. It's just gonna be a quick story time, it's not gonna be too long. I just wanted to just share this experience with y'all that I had in middle school, in the 7th grade. Yeah, I found this boy in middle school. Honestly, let me just say that the Chris back then is not the same Chris now. Okay, it's kind of the same Chris, but it's not all the way the same Chris. I don't know for people's trouble. Like, I really don't do. I run my business, I just do my thing. People come and look at my own trouble. But before I start this video, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and let's move forward. I think I was about like, okay, I don't remember my age, but I was like in the 7th grade. Chris, like I said, the Chris back then was not the same Chris now. I was more confrontational. A lot of things couldn't slide. You can't just act anyhow around me. Like, in middle school, like, you'd be dealing with people talking about you. You'd be dealing with people like bullying you for, not bullying, but like messing with you for no reason. Like, that nonsense did not slide with me. Like, if I felt some type of way about something, I'm going to confront that. I don't give it. It was after school this one day. And I was with my friends, you know, we're coming out of school, we're just walking. And I used to walk home at the time. That time, I didn't have motor, so I was just walking home. So I was coming out of the school, and usually, like, after school, like, we would all, like, be, like, outside, like, just standing. We're just causing trouble for no reason. Okay, so usually, there's this one boy that used to always cause trouble with everybody outside. Like, he was known for causing trouble outside. But he never caused trouble with me.
Bang!
That's the problem. That's the fact, the determining factor. So we're just outside. The boy comes around, you know, causing his usual trouble. So I'm just minding my own JJ. That's how the boy just comes. But this is half nose. He said something like,
yeah, so saw you look at me funny in the hallways or whatever. Like, I don't know, if you want something to, if you want to settle it, we can settle it here now. Like,
I'm like, who be this? First of all, at this time, I had just left private school. Cause I used to go to private school. I went to private school up to the 7th grade, so I was just now coming to public school. Stuff like this, I didn't see this nonsense. I wasn't dealing with fights in private school. Like, in private school, and I went to a Christian private school, so they were even talking about God 24/7. So even if you try to bring small fight, they'll go and bring up Philippians 4:17. The thing is, I was listening to him talk, but when he said, let's settle it, that word settle, it begins to shock my brain. I said, oh, you want to settle? I said, good. Number one, sir, what is your name? Because I don't even know who you are to begin with. I didn't even know who he was. Who are you? Excuse.
He's like, don't worry about my name, kid.
I said, don't worry about what your name is. So you don't know me from Adam. You don't know me from Eve. You come from my front, begin telling me, say you want fights. And you know me, I was very bush, so don't think that this bush started here. I was very bush back then. I said, people said they don't use your head for jazz. You don't even know who I be. I don't even know who you be, but you want fights. I said, no problem. I'm out where they make for that corner store. Because he was talking to me, but he was standing from a distance. I said, good. It's even better you're standing from a distance. Because if you're even closer than 3 inches, I would have finished you in this school. So as I'm getting louder, that's how everybody starts coming closer, you know, everybody's coming, surrounding, the teachers that are doing carpool, they're coming. At that point, I didn't care. I didn't care if the principal came. I didn't care if assistant principal came. I didn't care if police came. The boy don't talk, say he wants settle matter. So that matter we go settle, period. I said, if you dare. You cross this line. I said, if you cross this line, I will deal with you. I don't have time for talk. I don't have time for talking. If you want to do the talking, you better do the fighting. So that's how he's like, oh, you know, with his little, this stupid rawr XD boys surrounding him, all those his useless friends.
Crossed a lot.
Because he probably hasn't heard somebody say, cross this line and I'll deal with you before. You don't enter Wayo. Why don't enter Wayo? I just tell Una now. Because I'm a different human being. I don't really talk out. They breed me different. I'm a different breed. So the usual thing I used to do to other people when it comes to my own matter, power must change hand.
Oh, you're gonna draw your foot in the ground?
I drew my foot in the ground. Listen, so sometimes I have to do some drastic things. Drastic calls for desperate measure. I don't know if that. I drew my foot like, I said, cross the line. Cross him! I dare you, stupid fool. I know the boy did. The boy crossed the line. The boy actually took his two left foot, his two left legs, and crossed the line. I said, good. When I go here. So I said, cross the line. You actually crossed the line. So I said, cross the line. You actually crossed the line. That's how I grabbed his ears. So you decided to cross the line, right? If you don't know me, yo. I was grabbing this boy's ears outside. I said, so you decided to cross the line, right? If not for God and Christ in me, I will make that boy chop ground. You know what chop ground is? When you're dealing with somebody, and then you dig your hand in the ground and put the ground in their mouth. They get for chop ground. That's how the boy just went like this, bang, to my neck. I don't really know what kind of attack that was. He didn't put his hand to my neck like this. I was like, what kind of satanic activity? What is this nonsense? So you don't know how to fight? You don't know how to do satanic activity? Once he did that, I was just like, okay, wait. I just knew that I was messing with the wrong person because what is this? Doesn't this mean, what do you call it, devil? Isn't this a satanic sign? I was just like, God forbid. I know Dede, I took my legs, I said, thank you. Satan, no. Devil, no. I rebuke you in Jesus' name. I don't have time for warlock activities. I'm a child of God. I know the boy is even now in jail, so thank God for arresting my enemies. That was the like after that day, I never spoke to him. I actually never saw him again. So I don't know if it was a spirit that was coming to contest me in my school. So that's the end of that story time. But yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Share to your mom, your dad, your pastor, your barber. Yo, but that's co-worker, I don't know. Share it to everybody. Share it. Just share it. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Peace out. Oh, skillet.